Well, that's right, Dan. Officers with guns have been replaced by forensic teams with flashlights who are gathering evidence right behind me right now. As we understand, the gunman's body remains on the other side of that wall at this hour. They're in for a long night of investigating tonight. It was a heartbreaking and somber afternoon in Santa Cruz when squad cars from throughout the county descended on a shooting involving two of their own. Police cars swarmed the Branciforte neighborhood as word spread that two police detectives were shot and killed.
Shots fired, two down.
Our guys.
Police began a house-to-house search for the gunman as officers fanned out through the neighborhood. As many as five different SWAT teams scoured the area in search of the shooter. Then, more gunfire. Officers exchanged rapid gunfire along Doyle Avenue. Firefighters and neighbors ran for their lives.
What did you see when they fired the guns?
I ran and I fell on my face and the sidewalk, and the firemen were on top of me to keep me from getting shot and killed. But then they just started shooting at my apartment, and had I not come out and found out what was going on, I would be in my apartment and I might have gotten shot.
Witnesses say the shooter came out firing two guns.
We see this guy with long hair with two pistols, and we start hearing shots, and we just duck. And we're running, and there's shots getting fired everywhere. We hit the ground right when we saw the cop officer get down and get ready. We hit the ground right there, and then pop, pop, pop.
We're kind of, you know, doing zigzags to the cars and staying really, really low. And finally, once everything stopped, we ran inside Whole Foods.
It's certainly a sad day for Santa Cruz law enforcement, who have been dealing with a recent crime wave in the community. Now the violence has touched the department directly, and they're mourning the loss of two officers who were protecting the community. Dan and Aaron.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.